Hey, this is Pastor Rick. I have a question for you today. What do you like? Give me 5 minutes of your life. I want to just talk to you for a minute. What do you take delight in? Psalms 1 is this great place, right? We're studying. And Psalms has these great songs that they used to sing. Listen to what it says in verse 1. This is the beginning of the song. Blessed is the one. I won't do that. Okay, I won't sing it. Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. So here's the starting part question for you. What do you like? What do you delight in? Now, if we're honest, sometimes you delight in stuff that's not good, right? I won't name them. You do a better job than I can. But there are things that you shouldn't like. Certain foods would be a good starting place, right? Certain attitudes. Some of you like big, bad words. You say big, bad cuss words when you're mad. Now, or when you're not mad, you just do it all the time. Hi, blank, blank. How are you, blank, 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 blank to you too, blank, blank, triple blank. Some of you are just cussers. So whatever you are, the question is that good? Somebody says, no, but it feels good. Sometimes when people get on my nerves, okay, but is it good? Okay. Okay, some of you holy people right now, you're really church people. You're like, oh God, I can't believe this. I never cuss, Pastor. I'm not a bad person to say those bad words. But the truth is, you may delight in some other stuff, like being prideful or being harsh, or in this political environment, picking on people because they don't have your viewpoint. Ah, they got you on that one, didn't I? You got to be a Republican to be godly. That's what you say, right? Or you cannot if you're a Democrat. Okay, we have all of our views. But the problem is, if you're really honest and you're really truthful, being honest about what you delight in can be difficult, especially in this environment. It's difficult for you to say, I like advantage. I like a little fight. I like a little sparring. You know, I like a little bit of chop chop. You know, that's me. You don't really delight in the things that the Lord delights in. But blessed is the man who delights, look at the text again, in the law of the Lord. Now, the key thing is to delight in it correctly, to rightly divide it, not pull out parts you like. Oh boy, and here's the last part, and who meditates on it a lot, day and night. You're trying to find a way to make sure you're in sync with what he says. Not what you feel, but what he says. Now, here we go into an interesting conversation, because it's my conviction that what we do is we parcel and we dice and slice the Bible to fit our own personal preferences. And sometimes what that means is we're mean to people. And we see that a lot in our culture today. A lot of meanness going on, a lot of meanness. Oh boy, do you think God's pleased with the way we talk about each other? Especially online. Woo, mean stuff. Maybe you need to start liking being nice. You delight in the law of the Lord. You delight in doing it the way he would do it. Think about it the way he would think about it. Now that's going to take a little bit of you sitting back and saying, okay, I'm back there, he's in the front. In my attitude, I'll delight in his way. There's something about doing it God's way. And in this cultural environment, this voting environment, all the things that we're dealing with today, it's time for us to think about doing it his way, not our own way, not the way we're politically supposed to be doing it, you know, because we're a part of whatever party or whatever religious conviction. It's time for us to say, this needs to change. And maybe the way we engage needs to change. And so, blessed is the one who delights in the law of the Lord and he meditates. He thinks this way. It's really more about developing a way of thinking and living. That's what this verse is about. You not just doing it one day, but all the time. Your thinking process, your loving process can change. I tell people all the time, change the way you think, you change the way you feel. If you look at your cousin, you can't stand him, change the way you think about him. Look for the good. They got nice feet. I don't know. Name something. Find something good about them and try to think more positively. The Lord said, if you think with me, your life will be better. I got to go. My name is Pastor Ricky Temple. I hope it helped you a little bit. I hope you think about how you're living your life, and maybe God can help you if you allow him to. I'm sure he can. Father, bless those who've listened. May this be a changing moment for them. In Jesus' name, amen. I'll see you next time. I'm Pastor Overcoming by Faith right here in Savannah, Georgia. You can reach out to us on the information on your screen. Love to hear from you. Love to hear your prayer requests. I'll see you next time. Stay tuned. See you next time. Bye-bye. Stay sharp.